Hi, welcome to my channel. My name is Frank Quinones. I am the ambassador of reading. And, today's topic is a topic that I love. And I love it because it gave me my freedom at the age of 40, along with my wife. At 40, we were done. And it started with purchasing a home. So this one is called How to Buy a House. So we're gonna go step by step. I know that I'm speaking a little fast, so I better slow it down. Usually on all my videos, I get excited and I go really quick. So I'm gonna slow down a little bit because I wanna make sure that I hit the different points that we've put up here on this board so you can have as much clear view as possible. So down payment. There's a thing called FHA and you only need a 3.5%. Now, what does that mean? Well, you multiply whatever the price of the house is times 3.5%, and it's gonna give you the down payment. We did it for you at a $400,000 home. Mind you, there are different neighborhoods. If you go to a neighborhood that's not all that great, chances are homes are gonna be less than 400. If you go to an okay neighborhood, a good neighborhood, anywhere between 250, 500,000, you go to a better neighborhood, they're gonna be a little bit more. Whatever the number is, you multiply times 3.5. Now we did a $400,000 example for you. And when you multiply 3.5% times 400, all you need is $14,000 and you get into a home. Now you're wondering, how am I gonna get $400,000? I mean, $14,000 as a down payment? Watch my video called Pay Your Debt and Live Happy. It's got some great examples as to how to grab all your different debts, put them in order and pay it off. And once you pay it off, then you work on your $14,000, which is very feasible. Now, PMI, if you do an FHA, you're gonna have this thing called PMI and it's called private mortgage insurance. So you're gonna have that. You're not gonna get away from that because the banks wanna know that they're gonna get paid in case you default. So the second option is 20%, preferably not necessary. So you don't need to put 20% to get into a home. However, we did the number at a $400,000 home. At 20%, what you do is you multiply again, 20% times 400, and you would need $80,000. Now for some people, yeah, they're gonna be able to do it, especially if they don't have any debt. If they watch my video as to how to get rid of debt, chances are they're gonna get $80,000. They're gonna be able to come into the house. I'm gonna go back to this because I wanna get to the PMI. Now the PMI, look at this one. It's a big difference. Your payment, if you were to put 3.5% down, which is 14,000, at an interest rate of 4.25, your payment is gonna be an estimated 2,528. Out of the 2,528, $377 are used for insurance. That includes the PMI. Now, if we were to get rid of the PMI, it's gonna be about $300 less. At $300 less, imagine. We did the calculations with a 20% down at 4.25, and your payment is gonna be $1,930, a savings of $598. So yeah, it's beautiful to be able to have a 20% down, but if you don't have it, watch this, okay? You're gonna like this. If you don't have it at the beginning, what you can do is you can add to the principal payment, make your house a little bit more different, add a tree, add roses, cut the grass or whatever, paint it, and if it adds in value up to 20%, then you can request the bank to get rid of the PMI, and that money, don't use it. Watch my video, How to Pay Off a House in 10 Years or Less, and instead of using it unwisely, apply it towards a principal, and chances are you're gonna pay it in less than 10 years. It's a beautiful video. Watch the link. They're gonna put a link someplace around here. After you finish watching this video, of course, go to the link and watch the other video as to how to pay off a house in 10 years or less. Let me tell you a story. Now, let me go back to this. People want the 4-bedroom, 2 bathrooms. They want it. They're dreaming. They're a young couple. Yeah, let's go get the house. 4 bedrooms, 2 bathrooms. For what? That would be a want. If it's only him and her, they're thinking, yeah, but we're gonna have 3 boys and 2 girls and they're gonna need a place to stay and might as well. No, look, if you go with your needs, really, you only need 1 bedroom, him and her. But if you're thinking, yeah, we're going to have kids, 2 bedrooms, 1 bath. These ones here are gold. If you can find a 2 bedroom, 1 bath, they're gold. I know that I bought mine 2 bedrooms, 1 bath at $142,000 here in California. You can't find those anymore. And I knew what I was getting into. Right now, I modified it to a big, huge house, but it started off as a 2 bedroom, 1 bath. And the reason why there were so many 2 bedrooms, 1 bath is because after World War II, a lot of servicemen came back and they needed housing. So what did they do? They started building tract homes, and there was a whole bunch of them, and people didn't want them. People that know this information like me, we want those because they create a lot of money. Needs and wants. Fall in love with a number, not the house. Let me tell you a story. There's a house that my wife and I bought in East LA, and I would always go, I would drive to visit my mom in East LA because I was raised in East LA. And then I come back and I noticed that house needed some love, you know, needed some cleaning up. And I would always go by it and I would always ask, man, I wonder if the owner lives there. And then one day I got the courage, knocked on the door, and I asked him, are you the owner? He says, nope, I'm the renter. Why? And I said, well, because it's a good opportunity. If you're not the owner, ask the owner to sell it to you. And he says, no, he's crazy. He wants $100,000. I'm not going to pay $100,000 for this thing. And I said, do you have his number? And he says, yes, I do. Do you mind giving it to me? And he says, no, I don't. And he gave it to me. I called the owner. It turned out that the owner didn't want the house. This guy doesn't want the house. Guess what? I want the house. And my wife and I bought it for $64,000. I know. Incredible. You can't do that nowadays. It was just amazing. It was so beautiful. So what I did, check this out. We pressure washed it. I called my brothers. I said, help me clean out some of this trash. I think we took out 3 truckloads worth of trash. We pressure washed it. I painted it 2 colors, green and then white trimming. I built a wall, planted a tree, fixed the stairs going up. And I rented it to the guy. He started falling in love with it. And he asked me one day, would you sell it to me? And I said, yeah, if you're willing to buy it. Guess what? He paid 3 times the amount for a paint job that only took 2 colors, pressure wash, 2 colors, a wall, a tree, and some stairs. So those are gold. I mean, the guy fell in love with the house instead of the number. If he would have known what you're listening to right now and what I know, imagine all the money he would have made. Oh, well, you know what? The owner doesn't want it. And if he doesn't want it, let me get it cleaned up. Let me paint it. Let me make it the way I like it. And he would have made a lot of money. But instead, he didn't want to do the work. And you know what? If you do a little bit of work, it's already proven. And look at all. There are so many books that you can get or so many videos that you can watch, especially this one, that tell you if you the house will go up in value if you do certain things like plant rose bushes, plant grass, clean it up, set a wall, do any of that. Now, PMI, a lot of people don't know this. And because you're part of our channel, let me tell you, this is probably going to make you money. A lot of people don't know that they can get rid of the PMI. How do you get rid of the PMI, you ask? Well, you have to have 20% of value on your behalf. So how do you add 20% in value? It's not that hard. People think, oh, I have to wait for the economy to go up, for houses to go up. You can do it yourself. And I did it. I told you the story about the house that we bought it at 64. He paid 3 times the amount. That was 300% in value. That was high value. How do you do it for you? Remodel the kitchen or add a bathroom or plant some rose bushes. Make it look nice. Then you go tell the bank, hey, I want you to remove the PMI. They're going to tell you, but why? You're going to tell them because my house is worth this much. And they're going to go, really? Who says so? Well, look around the comps. Look at how much the houses are worth around there. Yeah, but your house is this. Go check it out. I already had a realtor tell me the value, and they tell me it's worth this much. They have to prove it that it's not. And chances are they're not going to want to spend money. So guess what? You're going to release $300 that can now go to the principal. And if you watch my video, how to pay off a house in 10 years or less, and you apply it, you'll be out of your debt in about 10 years, more or less, maybe less. I think less. Anyway, we're going to call it at that. I'm going to review the whole thing as to how to buy a house. So down payment, you could go with an FHA at 3.5%. Get whatever number you get, 200, 300, 400, multiply it times 3.5, and it'll give you a number, and that's what you're going to need as a down payment. You could also do a 20%, which means you multiply the number times 20%, and you'll get a number. In this case, it was 80,000, and that's what you're going to need. That one doesn't charge you PMI, so you have an advantage. Needs and wants. Don't buy more than what you need. There's a law, I don't know if it's for the whole United States, but I know it's for California, where you can do a 1031 exchange. And if you do a 1031 exchange, they don't tax you a penny. You just grab that money from the small house and you transfer it over to a bigger house. You make all that money, you move into the new house with maybe even a lower payment. Don't go spending it anywhere else. Just throw it all in there. Get rid of your mortgage. I could explain what mortgage means in another video. From what I found out, fall in love with a number. You want to fall in love with a number. How much is a house? Well, it's this much because it needs a little bit of love, TLC as they call it. Well, if all the houses are selling at 300 and this one is selling at 200, you want to buy. You're falling in love with a number. You're not falling in love with a house. The renter that I sold it to, he fell in love with a house. Well, he paid for it. I did the work, and I'm sure if you knew we're going to get paid 200% or 300% more than the value of it, you would want to do the work too. So that sums it up. If you put a 3.5%, you're going to get charged PMI. If you don't, if you pay a 20% plus, you're not going to get charged PMI. That sums it up. So if you want to watch the video, how to pay off a house in 10 years or less, because you already have one, follow the link down someplace around here. I don't know where they're going to put it. Or if you don't have the down payment, you want to watch my video that says, pay off your debt and live happy, get rid of your debt, get started with your down payment, and purchase your home. Very well, we're going to leave it at that. Till next time, your friend, the ambassador of reading, Frank Quiñiguez, wishing you well today and always, knowing that you will find and get what you are looking for. Congratulations, and thank you for watching until the end. If you like the information, there are more videos that you can watch. Also, if you're not part of this community yet where you're subscribed, you can subscribe down here. Also, make your comments. I love reading comments, and share, because that's what makes the channel grow. Thank you and welcome to the channel.